Welsh human rights strategy post-Brexit. In the last few years, the devolved Welsh Government has been working together with disabled people's organisations to advance equality, human rights, and accessibility to services for people with impairments. The Action on Disability, the Right to Independent Living consultation and policy document launched in September 2019 sets a vision of an accessible Wales in line with the social model of disability. But as the UK falls out of sync with international and European legislation, where will that leave us come the 31st of December? What can we do to protect our rights in Wales if national equality legislation is weakened by Brexit? We ask Rhian Davis, Disability Wales CEO, to tell us about the framework and how it will be key in Welsh equality legislation.
Disability Wales is particularly aware that when we work at the UK level with our sister organisations across the UK, and we're aware that it seems to be more challenging to engage with the UK government on disability rights issues, but that's very different from the situation in Wales, where in addition to the Framework for Action on Disability, we also have the Disability Equality Forum, and that provides an accountability mechanism, but there isn't a similar mechanism in that the UK government has put in place. So our concern is that if the differentiation gets even wider between Wales and UK policies on the issues that Welsh government doesn't have responsibility for, which in particularly includes benefits, pension issues, and equality legislation, the ability to lobby for change and improvement will become even weaker.
To learn more about the Welsh perspective on disability rights after Brexit, follow the links in the description box below.